Respected principal, teachers and all my dear friends, a very warm and calm good morning to one and all. On this morning, I am here to give something special, which is more special. Before that, hope you are safe at home. So today is a day which everyone needs to be remembered. Today is the 5th Remembrance Day of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. On the fateful Monday evening of July 27, 2015, India's most loved president Abul Pakir Jainul Abdin Abdul Kalam, better known as APJ Abdul Kalam, was delivering a lecture at 11 a.m. Shillong. Creating a lovable planet Earth was not only the topic of his lecture, which he had just begun to give before the students, but was also the subject of a book which he could not finish in his lifetime. He was one of the most popular president of India, and people remember him fondly as he continued to inspire everyone with his life. It is indeed rare for the world to witness a leader that is intelligent, wise, selfless, and loved by all. Abul Pakir Jainul Abdin Abdul Kalam was one such leader. Furthermore, he was a man who has a very strong appeal among the masses. Moreover, his political stature is way above the discriminatory lines of caste religion. Kalam came to this world on 15th October 1931, a time of British occupation. He was born to a Tamil Muslim family in Tamil Nadu. Father was a boat owner and mother was a wife, housewife. Furthermore, Kalam had 5 siblings and he was the youngest. In school, Kalam was an average friend, but he was still hardworking and bright. It is a big motivation for all the average students out there. Being average, you must never ever underestimate yourself and continue doing the hard work. In year 1960, APJ Abdul Kalam's graduation took place from the Madras Institute of Technology. The association of Kalam took place with the Defence Research and Development Service. Furthermore, he joined as a scientist at the Aeronautical Development Establishment of the Defence Research and Development Organization. These were the beginning achievements of his prestigious career as a scientist. The government of India became aware of the brilliance of this man and made him the chief executive of the Integrated Guided Missiles Development Program. Furthermore, this program was responsible for the research and development of missiles. The achievements of this distinguished man didn't stop there. More success was to come in the form of Agni and Prithvi missiles. Once again, Kalam was influential in the development of these missiles. It was during his tenure in IGMDP that Kalam played an instrumental role in the development of missiles like Agni and Prithvi. Moreover, Kalam was a key figure in the Pokhran 2 nuclear test. The honor of being the 11th president of India went to APJ Abdul Kalam. This marked under tremendous feat in his already venerable career. This highly acclaimed personality became president after winning the 2002 presidential election of massive margin. There were many quotes which gives inspiration to many person who were in the end of the streams and when they turned to give up. A few of them are: you have to dream before your dreams come true. To succeed in your mission, you must have single-minded devotion to your goal. Great dreams of great dreamers are always transcended. You see, God helps only people who work hard. That principle is very clear. Man needs his difficulties because they are necessary to enjoy success. These are some of his quotes. And Dr. Kalam had 3 steps to find or give to achieve a goal, which may be helpful also for us. It was finding an aim in life before you are 20 years old. Acquire knowledge continuously to reach this goal. Work hard and persevere so you can defeat all the problems and succeed. There are some interesting facts. Somewhat it will make us laugh, but there is more to think. Kalam used it to read both Quran and Bhagavad Gita. Kalam gave away his salary to charity. Once Kalam addressed 400 students without electricity at the place, powering Rashtrapati Bhavan with solar energy. These are the interesting facts. Okay, saying that Indian people love APJ Abdul Kalam would be a massive underestimate. The Indian people have a huge affection for this man. Consequently, he was known as the people president. The man who had to face only a few critics in his entire life. The entire nation reacted to his death with grief. Kalam was a great asset to India. His unparalleled contribution in the field of science took India to new heights. Kalam's presidency was characterized by peace and efficiency. The death of the recipient of Padma Bhushan in 1981, Padma Vibhushan in 1990 and the Bharat Ratna in 1997 was a shock to the nation. Dr. Kalam will forever be remembered for his contributions to the country's nuclear and space program. His books, Wings of Fire and Ignited Minds will always be an inspiration to many. The 4,000-word lecture remained unfinished as the missile man of India collapsed. He was rushed in an ambulance to the nearby Brittany Hospital, but later that evening he was declared to have died of a cardiac arrest. Leaders keep on coming and going. Everyone's in a while. If we came across someone as a preeminent as Kalam, his name will certainly go down in history as one of the greatest presidents that India has ever seen. Moreover, people will also remember him as a brilliant scientist. This man was a precious gem for each and every Indian. I'm concluding my words. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home. Stay safe.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am indeed delighted to be with the honorable members of the European Parliament on the occasion of the Golden Jubilee Year of the European Union. I am reminded of the dream of an Indian poet, Kaniyan Pungunes Yadumure Yavarin Kelis, which means I am a world citizen. Every citizen is my own kith and kin, he said 3,000 years back. As we say in India, where there is righteousness in the heart, where there is righteousness in the heart, there is beauty in the character. When there is beauty in the character, there is harmony in the home. When there is harmony in the home, there is harmony, there is an order in the nation. When there is order in the nation, there is peace in the world.